As we begin our 219 episodes, the first show is going to be on offensive zone strategies and plays. We are going to build off concepts that we talked about in the first part of the year on breakouts and rush options, and we're going to carry it, as I said, into the offensive zone. These are the seven skills that you need to execute the offensive zone plays and strategies. Puck protection, winning loose puck battles, quick release shots, catch and release shots, change the shooting angle, passing and deception skills, D, shooting quick and getting shots through from the blue line, ability to use cutbacks and beat opponents down low, and finally, net screen, quick hands, and tipping pucks at the net. The first concept in the offensive zone I want to talk about is a lot of teams practice the cycle, but for me, players supporting the cycle should only be when the puck carrier is in trouble. If the puck carrier is not in trouble, then the forwards should support the slot and the net area. The defense are available on the blue line. The next concept is a high roll play. So instead of a corner cycle, we're doing a high roll play where you cycle over top of the circles and one of your defense slashes in to create room and space. The first forward, instead of cycling in the corner, carries the puck over top. The defenseman slashes in. The other defense covers up for him defensively, and then you can shoot or make a play. When playing against teams that collapse low in coverage and you recover a puck in the corner, your first play should be to move it low high right away. When you move the puck low high, it's often an advantage if you can create a three high look where the forward moving the puck skates up the boards, the defenseman sprints to the middle, the other D opens up on the other side, and now you play them 3-on-2 up high. Sometimes when the defense get the puck on a low high play, they don't have any options. There's pressure on them. So the best thing to do is to reset it behind the net for your net forward to roll off, pick up the puck, and start to move east-west behind the net. And finally, anytime your forwards are moving up the boards or behind the net, your defense should activate. They should slash in, whether the strong side defense moves in first or the backside defense moves in, only one at a time. The other player has to cover up, and this will create more seams, more options for the forwards to create, again, a grade A scoring chance. I would encourage all coaches to make sure you practice the skills involved in these offensive zone strategies and then work with your players in more 5-on-0 situations, running through the different plays, the different strategies, so that the execution is perfect.